Okay, today kicks off Healthy Weight Week, and joining us to talk about healthy and delicious cooking is Ruth Milstein. She is the gourmet cook and author of the award-winning cookbook, Cooking with Love, Ventures into the New Israeli Cuisine, and you can buy it online at Amazon.com from the publisher TakePublishing.com, but I really encourage you to also visit her website, RuthMilstein.com, or you can also check out her new regular culinary It's a recipe column in the food and drink department on BigBlendMagazine.com, and you can also listen to her past interview. Hi, Ruth. Welcome to Champagne Sundays. How are you?
Hi, Lisa. How are you?
Oh, we're doing good over here. And, you know, talking about in cooking with love, you focus on Mediterranean and Israeli cuisine, and, you know, looking at the photos in your book, you know, your recipes are so colorful. Does color indicate more health?
Yes, absolutely. Okay. More color, healthier.
Okay. So, I know that's the thing. I think a lot of people now with their kids, they're so used to McDonald's and all those wonderful fast food places. And I'm sorry, McDonald's, I'm being sarcastic here. But I know that they're all trying. But making something at home that your kids are going to eat, I mean, that is a difficult thing, that, you know, something nutritious. And I was looking at your recent recipe, turkey balls with peanut butter and ginger. Number one, peanut butter, I wouldn't have thought to put that with poultry, but it sounds actually really good. I'm reading the recipe. I'm going to try making it.
Try.
Do you think the peanut butter is something that's going to make the kids enjoy it more?
At least to try it, because children, you can program the tongue. It's healthier, it's less oil. And on the side, you can, as a carb, either baked potato, which all of us love it, and it's healthy baked potato.
Absolutely.
Or brown rice. Or brown rice. Again, mm-hmm. you can program the tongue of children, even adults.
Mm-hmm. They get used to
the taste. I used to cook a lot years ago white rice. Not anymore. Last 5 years, only brown rice.
Mm-hmm.
And we love it in our home.
It really is a change of your mind, and I think the sooner you start with your children, the better.
Yes, and make it as a lifestyle. In the shopping cart, if you go to the market, but don't you bring enemy to the house? Absolutely not. So don't. Bring only healthy food. Healthy food.
That's right. A good point.
So, you know, it's the same thing as, you know, if your child wants a cookie, give them a piece of fruit.
Yeah, yes, but if he eats fruits, if he eats a lot of vegetables, if he eats a healthy dinner, he can eat a piece of cookie, why not? He can eat a piece of cake. Even as adults, yes, if we eat healthy dinner, we can eat a piece of chocolate after that or a piece of cookie. Or personally, I eat a jam that I make. It's from fruit, sugarless or with sugar, on a piece of toast, I'm happy.
You know, I think you've got something about the frozen vegetables because, number one, if you're into buying organic, you can.
Can eat the organic. It's not organic.
Yeah, and the thing, when they grow them,
yes,
and when they harvest the frozen, they've been doing a lot of studies that prove, and they always taste sweeter.
It's sweeter frozen. And healthier.
Yeah, because they pick them right at the time that they're ripe.
They freeze them in four hours, they freeze them.
Hmm. Okay. Now, the one thing you talked about is you go to a butcher for your meat. Is that something you do? Would you prefer going to a butcher than to a regular grocery store? Do you think
I go to the butcher? I buy everything fresh. First, I want to see what I'm buying. I don't buy packed. It's me personally.
Okay. So when you're buying like the turkey, because it's mince, right?
No, I get a chunk of turkey and I ask him to grind for me.
Ah. So that's a lot
I know what grind. The same with the meat. Mm-hmm. I buy shoulders or silver top, which is very long fat, and I ask him to grind it. So I know how much fat there is there. And I ask him before to trim all the fat. And if I want to add fat, I will add olive oil.
Right.
So I want to make hamburger from red meat, from shoulders with almost zero fat. It's a lot of less fat. I will add a little bit of olive oil, which is healthier.
I'm going to the butcher from now on. I could actually walk to him from here. But that's the thing. I think, we don't know. I don't know what I'm looking at half of the time when I go and I'm looking at all the meat cuts and everything. I don't know. I don't know when it's been ground up, when you buy the ground
meat. I would tell you what's ground. It's at an end.
Ew.
At an end. It's ground. Otherwise, it's come, it stay one piece.
Yeah. You talk about make-ahead meals. Are you of the thought process of, like, my mom, Nancy, here? She always
Hi,
says,
Nancy.
Okay.
Hi.
She's always said, we've got to make our meals before and then just put them in the freezer, take them out, and cook them when we need them.
It's so easy for a working woman.
Yeah.
So
would you do it at a week at a time?
A week at a time, usually, yes. People ask me, you have a big freezer? No, I don't. I have normal size of freezer because I prepare for the week ahead. I don't prepare it for another 2-3 months.
Yeah, just for the week. So you,
yeah, for the week
you
ahead.
Go get your stuff, come home, unpack it, cook everything, yes. Freeze it, and you're done for the week.
Try my substitute mayonnaise. I have two of them.
Uh-huh.
Mayonnaise is all egg yolk and oil.
A mayonnaise.
Try my mayonnaise. It's one made from yogurt and one made from tofu.
Mm-hmm. Well, we need to talk about that, too. And this is the thing. You know, you're talking about all these, you know, making your own mayonnaise, right?
Yes.
And going to the butcher, I think it's going to cost less because you're not paying for all that fancy packaging.
Yes.
But if you're working ahead a week, aren't we saving money as well?
Absolutely. It's healthier and we're saving money.
Ruth, you rock. I think this is amazing. I think a lot of people, you're going to be saving them, you know, the time, the money, and making colorful food that their kids will eat. And they'll be able to actually sit down at the table with their kids because they're not still in the kitchen.
And most important, healthy.
Healthy.
Eat healthier.
Right.
Eat healthier.
Healthy.
And the children are going to love it. As I said, you can program the tongue.
Right.
Yes.
So if you program their tongue now, they'll be healthy, and then they will stay healthy for the rest of their life because it becomes a lifestyle.
They
get
and if you don't buy junk food, they can't eat it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
You do rock. Everybody,
excellent.
Get a copy of Ruth's book, Cooking with Love, Ventures into the New Israeli Cuisine. She's also got it on audio if you want to prefer an audio book with CDs and you want to listen to it. It's a great thing. As you're cooking, you could be listening to Ruth telling you how to do it. It's all available on Amazon.com from her publisher, TapePublishing.com, but also visit her website, RuthMilstein.com, and also check out her recipe column in the Big Blend magazine food and drink department, and you can listen to our past interviews, and we're just really happy to have Ruth on board with us.
Thanks, Ruth.
Thanks, Ruth.
Thank you, Lisa. Thank you, Nancy.
You take care.